started this build by taking a concept I've seen in the past with 3D prints. Take an object from real life and add 3D parts to it until it's no longer recognizable as the original. I wanted to try my hand at this and learn some 3D modeling in the process. I started by getting some accurate measurements of the cans I was going to use. The diameter is the most important part. Looks like they're the standard 66 millimeters in diameter. Most drinking containers are of this size. From here, I tried some different thicknesses for the walls of my 3D prints. This one was too thick, this one was too thin. This one's just right. From here, the concept evolved a bit more. Could I make the base of the silos mostly from skewers or popsicle sticks, and then have these sort of 3D printed connectors? After a few more iterations, I got to this set of parts. Let's give the 3D printer some work to do, shall we? For those of you with access to 3D printers, I made these parts as well as a set of instructions available for a few bucks on my store, linked in the description. Assembling these was pretty straightforward from this point. I'd spent a long time with these parts inside the 3D modeling software, and it felt liberating to work with my hands and touch the parts in real life for once. I printed off enough parts to make a single silo, as well as this double structure. Maybe I'll learn some things while building the first one, so I can make the second one better. Hot glue worked well here, but super glue would likely be neater. Also, the bamboo stir sticks look nicer on the second set, but the connectors work with both. I'm actually really pleased with how these connectors turned out. The rivets and sharp angles give them an old-timey wrought iron look. Kind of like the construction of the struts on the Eiffel Tower. Make sure you gently press that like button if you like these two. Aligning the tank holder is probably the trickiest part. Cutting all the skewers to the exact same length helps keep it in place. And a little bit of wiggling is needed as I set the tank to make sure it's level. The vertical supports slot nicely into the holes as well, and they add a lot of visual appeal to the whole can. They practically make you forget what it's made from. A little bit of super glue to each connection to keep this wall secured as well. Just adding the last few bits here. This is the top cap going on, and the little pipe adapter. One going on top and one going on the bottom. It's made to fit these paper straws, which slots in to make a drain pipe here. To make the walkway on top, the leg supports work with a variety of different materials. I did one with canvas mesh, and another one with some chipboard and mesh tape to get a similar effect. Use what works for you. I'm also fitting on the ladder included in the kit. It comes in three parts. I figured I would just overlap the bottom part instead of trying to precisely measure the size of it. To give the silos a realistic scale handrail, I'm using some half-inch chicken wire for railing as well as the cage for the ladder. It gives a ton of detail for not a lot of work. To get the curved cage, I bent a section of three links around the handle of the broom. You can make railings out of popsicle sticks or skewers as well, or cut some out of cardboard to fit in between the railing key slots. Painting this was initially going to be real simple, but I wanted to push myself to do better. I did a gray spray prime outside, and then did a soft zenithal highlight with an airbrush. I picked out the tank in this Soviet turquoise color, and all the metal supports in burnt umber. To get the gritty texture of rust and corrosion, I mixed some brown paint with tile grout in a thick mixture. Then, using a brush, I applied it on parts where I thought rust would build up, taking care not to go overboard. Also, use a really beat up brush for this, because the tile grout is not kind to your nice brushes. The color of the grout when dried wasn't really what I was going for, so I hit the silos with a dark brown wash to tone it down. That's more like it. At this stage, I also added some decals to thank some of my latest patrons, Andrew and Sierra. I'll make these files available on Patreon as well for everyone that supports me at no extra cost. I blended the yellow background of the text printouts with one section of the tank. To get good coverage with yellow, it saves a lot of time to undercoat in white first, and then come in with various layers of yellow. Now that dark wash also muted a lot of the turquoise, so to bring some of that back, I dabbed a very watered down version of the color back onto the spots. I wanted to glaze that contrast back up a bit. This step was quite messy, so another pass with a gray on the vertical bars to clean up some of those lines and set it apart from that turquoise. From there, dry brushing some metallics, hitting the yellows with some orange washes, and finally coming in with some heavy-handed red pigments to really punch up that color of the rust. Stick around for some awesome shots of these on the table, and otherwise, I'll catch you on the next one.